Doctor, it seems you've had a busy day. Would you like to tell me about it?
Memory's a little fuzzy.
Understandable. Regeneration can do that to a person.
How do you know about regenerations?
I have had a little experience. 13, to be exact.
Who are you?
Oh, my dear Doctor, you have been naive.
The Master.
I'm almost glad your little accident didn't cost you your life. I have a much bigger plan for you now.
Where's the real Arden?
Dr. Adon is indisposed for the time being.
How much time?
Oh, all of it.
You fiend!
Allow me to show you why I brought you here. The Mind Energy Transfer Unit. Since you succeeded in returning the Great Key to Gallifrey, you have an advantage I do not. An advantage I plan to exploit using this device. With it, I shall exchange minds with you. My mind shall inhabit your body, and yours shall inhabit mine.
No!
Your regeneration will make it all the more perfect. No one will suspect that the Doctor is a... Oh, what do they call it? A Trojan horse?
You won't get away with it. A civilized man can act like a savage, but a savage can never act like a civilized man.
That, Doctor, would cost you your life, but for I need your pitiful body. No use struggling. Your regeneration has left you weak as a babe. Now, let the proceeding begin.
Now, Doctor, you are mine. Well, I must say, your taste in clothes has certainly drifted more toward the flamboyant. Although I can't complain. I really didn't look forward to navigating with that obnoxious scarf of yours.
No one will ever believe that you're me.
But of course they will. That is one of the conveniences of regeneration. No one knows who the new Doctor is. Oh, I assume you'll keep your naive penchant for interference and your eternal optimism. Those should be easy enough to imitate. I only need do so for a little while.
So, you need free run of Gallifrey.
Clever as ever, Doctor, but there's nothing you can do to stop me now, for you are now the notorious renegade. The Time Lords will welcome me with open arms for restoring their precious Great Key, and I shall enter the Panopticon in the cloak of your two companions.
No! Leave them out of it!
What? The Doctor not accompanied by his loyal travel mates? Now that would raise suspicion, wouldn't it? No. They too shall serve me, for as long as they remain useful. Would that I can stay and enjoy your charming company, Doctor, but the time has come for us to part ways. There's no need for such vain efforts. I have rendered you quite immobile, and when the transfer unit is fully recharged, it shall automatically engage again. Unfortunately, there will be no one here for you to exchange bodies with this time. Your mind will be ripped from you and, well, it has been an entertaining rivalry.
No!
Goodbye, Doctor.
Well, I guess security has something going for it after all. Can't you think of a way out?
No air ducts this time.
We can't just sit here.
If you have anything constructive to offer, I'm willing to listen. Otherwise, we're just going to have to wait until another opportunity presents itself.
If another one ever does.
Someone's at the door.
Who is it?
I don't know. Here, hold this.
What do you want me to do with it?
When they come in, hit them with it.
What?
This is our opportunity. Now don't blow it.
Doctor!
How did you get in? Everything's all straightened out. It's time for us to leave.
What about the detective sergeant? How'd you get past him?
He seems to have more pressing problems than worrying about us. Your condition seems to have stabilized somewhat.
What? Oh, yes, quite. You could say I feel like a new man.
What did Dr. Adon say?
A clean bill of health. Rather interesting fellow, really. I'm all sorry I shan't be seeing him again. Now, shall we be going?
To the TARDIS!
To the TARDIS.
Oh, I've been dying to see your ship.
Why, my dear Mister, I wouldn't have you miss it for the world. Now, why did I put that homing device?
You gave it to me, Doctor.
Oh, so I did. Well, come along.
No use. I wonder how much time there is. Well, you didn't have to give me that directive and answer. Oh, great. What else can go wrong? Oh, no. Oh, no! My nose itches! Help!
Nurse, have you seen Detective Sergeant Bishop?
Sorry, I haven't. Wasn't he guarding those two brought from Pharaoh's?
I've had him paged, but he hasn't answered.
He should be just down the hall. That's where they were keeping them.
Thought they were in the West Wing.
The Detective Sergeant wanted them someplace more secure after they got out last time.
Show me which room they're using.
It's right over here.
Funny. No one's here. They must have left.
I would have seen them if they did, Administrator.
What's this? Some kind of doll?
Strangest looking doll I've ever seen. It almost looks like...
Doctor, how much further?
You have patience, my dear Miss Dara. They say it is a virtue.
But we've been walking for hours.
A mere drop in the proverbial bucket for a time, Lord. I do regret the inconvenience for your sake, though. Humans have sub-limited lifespans. If this were a proper working TARDIS, we could have it come to us.
You mean you're taking us on a ship that doesn't work properly?
Why, you're not frightened, are you? Trust me, I would do nothing to harm you.
There it is, Doctor. Over there.
But it's just a police box. I thought they were all out of commission.
Learn to look beyond the superficial. Appearances can be quite deceiving.
Police public call box. Police telephone free for use of public. Pull to open.
After you.
I don't believe it. How?
How what?
It's bigger on the inside than it is on the out.
Transcendental quantum physics, actually.
Huh?
It's far beyond your rudimentary comprehension. Just say it's bigger on the inside than it is on the out.
Wait a minute.
Commander, would you care to escort our guest? I'm sure Miss Hamilton would like to see more of what the TARDIS has to offer, and unfortunately I'm rather tied up for the moment.
Of course.
Do try to keep it simple, though. I wouldn't want to tax either of you.
Did you hear that?
Come along, Miss Hamilton.
But...
I said come along.
Primitive fools. Ah, this panel is a mess. How does he operate this thing? Gyro stabilizers where the navigational console should be. Power distribution net all in disarray. Let's see. At least he hasn't touched that. Course update. 10-0-11-0-0 by 02. Thus rides Apollyon.
I don't care if it's regeneration or whatever. That was rude.
The Doctor certainly is acting out of character.
What's wrong with him?
I don't know. Starfleet knows very little about the Time Lords. They keep pretty much to themselves.
I thought you aliens knew all about each other.
The Doctor at least has his regeneration as his excuse.
What if he doesn't get any better?
Fundamental personality traits should remain. He's basically a good person. Those characteristics should begin to manifest themselves again.
And if they don't?
I guess something might have gone wrong with his regeneration, then.
Great. And then what?
I don't know. We've dematerialized. We're in his hands now.
You mean you don't know how to fly this ship?
His technology is beyond me. We'll just have to wait and see.
Help! Why can't anyone hear me? Oh my. This is not a good sign. The transfer unit's recharge cycle must be complete. That means... Oh, Doctor, I'm too young to die. I'm only 384. Or is it 547? That's the trouble with time travel. You lose all track of time. This is uncomfortable.
Yes, this is definitely somewhat annoying. My mind is being ripped from me! What happened? The power. There was a short circuit. Oh, Doctor, you are one lucky Time Lord. Somebody up there likes me. The whole unit's been disabled. Wait a minute. There's something not quite right here. The power line. It's connected to... Of course! No wonder why no one could hear me. I'm inside the Master's TARDIS. This guy's an examination room. I think it's time to see things as they really are. Well, now we won't have to be looking at any holographic images anymore. So, it seems like the Master's been updating his TARDIS. Type 73, I believe. Very brave of him to leave it open for anyone to walk in, though I doubt anyone can see past his illusion. Better close it off just as well, so no one accidentally wanders in now. There now, let's see. I need to find out if he's gotten to my TARDIS. Now, where is that monitor switch? Ah, here it is. At least he hasn't moved that. Lock onto my TARDIS. Blast! He's got it working! Protected course? Gallifrey? All right. If he wants to play with my TARDIS, he should have no objections to me using his. Now, how do you activate this thing? Ah! His panels are all messed up. Navigational console is... Oh, so that's where it's supposed to go. Well, no matter. Course plot, 10-0-11-0-0-by-0-2. Dematerialization... Now. Now! Huh. All it takes is a little technical know-how. Ole ole awesome, Flame Master. Here I come. Let's just hope he doesn't know I got away from his little toy.
Predictable as ever, Doctor. But you shan't stop me now.
What the feather carb?
What's happening?
Bastard, dirty console. Doctor, what's going on? Don't you people know how to maintain a properly functioning capsule?
What?
I do apologize. I'm afraid I'm still a little disoriented from my ordeal. I must have pressed the wrong button.
Are you all right, Doctor?
Yes, quite all right. I assure you.
You just don't seem yourself.
A mere happenstance, a byproduct of regeneration. I will settle down in due course.
Course, yes. Where are you taking us?
We have a little unfinished business to tend to, I'm afraid. It won't take too long. Our course is Gallifrey.
Gallifrey?
Another planet?
You seem to be of the adventurous type, Miss Terra. Surely you wouldn't pass up the chance to broaden your horizons.
Not on your life!
Excellent. I knew I could count on you. Now gather up your finest ensembles, for we have an inauguration to attend.
Power is only beginning to be restored to vital functions.
I've given you all the men I can spare. I must be left some to keep order.
I understand, but the situation is still...
Castellan Dominic? External tracking is picking up an approaching unregistered time capsule.
Unregistered?
Can you identify the transponder code?
I'm checking. Registry reads Alpha Z99 oblique 35 Delta.
The Doctor.
I thought his TARDIS had been decommissioned.
It seems that he was able to take advantage of our preoccupation with Antithesis and recapture his ship.
Castellan, I...
Sir, he's requesting clearance to land.
Really? By all means, give it to him. Cardinal, would you care to join me at the Panopticon? This should be interesting.
Castellan Dominic, we meet again.
Doctor, you're looking... well?
Do you like it? I think it has just the right amount of aristocracy to it, don't you?
And who are these you have brought with you? You know our policy against aliens.
Aliens? Or are you people so stuck up, Doctor?
Cardinal Royce, It's always a pleasure. You must forgive my companion here. She is from Earth, a less developed civilization. May I introduce Miss Dara Hamilton, full of life and vigor. I'm sure you both remember Commander Triad.
I must say I'm rather surprised to see you back on Gallifrey so soon, Doctor. I thought you would be roaming time and space like you usually do, forever sticking your nose into other people's business.
There are more urgent matters that need attending to, Castellan. Matters which I would like to take up with Cardinal Royce, if you don't mind.
Doctor,
Castellan will be good enough to look after you, I'm sure. Cardinal, if I may speak with you in private.
Of course, Doctor. This way. Of all the...
I've never been on an alien planet before. I've never been beyond South Wales.
Miss Hamilton, if you don't mind, please wait here and I will assign someone to look after your needs.
Not a very friendly bunch.
This isn't downtown London.
They could at least try to be a little more courteous.
I wonder what the doctor's up to.
Now, Doctor, what can I do for you?
A terrible tragedy has befallen Gallifrey. Wouldn't you say so, Cardinal?
Yes. With the loss of both Chancellor Gherkin and President Caelid, we have a gap at the very summit of the Time Lord hierarchy.
As Caelid was of the Patrick's chapter, and you are now head of that chapter, it would seem you are now leading the High Council.
Only until we can establish a new Lord President.
Have you decided on any acceptable candidates yet, Cardinal?
Well, Cardinal Lannan would seem like a good choice, but I think he's still a little too young, and still a little too much under your influence, I would say.
I've often thought I've neglected my duties here on Gallifrey for far too long. Perhaps I should re-establish myself on the High Council.
Oh, Doctor, I think your days on the High Council are long over.
Oh, I would disagree. I fancy I should even make a good choice for the presidency.
Now, Doctor, be reasonable. Your reputation does not speak well of you. You were no less of a renegade than that master fellow we had here.
Was it not I who restored the Great Key back to Gallifrey?
It was also you who let it slip into the Master's hands in the first place.
Cardinal, what is stopping me right now from claiming the presidency for myself?
Well, for one thing, you would need the support of the High Council.
But, my friend, you are the High Council. They will do whatever you say.
Doctor, I have no intention of recommending you for the position of the High Council President. You have no respect for authority.
Oh, my dear Cardinal, I think you will. For I am your master, and you will obey me.
What's going on?
I don't know. You two, come with me.
Where are we going?
There was just an emergency session of the High Council. It seems that the doctor just got himself appointed president.
President?
I am to take you to be properly attired. You are to attend the induction.
I can't believe it. The doctor, president.
Neither can I.
That shouldn't have done that. Come on, Doctor, get a hold of yourself. What's the worst that can happen? The Master's only on Gallifrey, disguised as me, with my TARDIS, and with Mark and Dara. What possible trouble could he cause? Got to get more speed out of this thing. It was definitely not that button. Blast! I wish I knew what was happening over there.
Mark, relax a little. You're making me nervous. This is supposed to be a happy occasion.
There's something not quite right. The Doctor despises the Time Lords. Why does he suddenly want to be their leader?
Perhaps he's had a change of heart. Hearts.
But for the Time Lords to suddenly forgive the Doctor's past and give him such a powerful position straight away? That doesn't make any sense.
You're too suspicious of everything. But look, something's happening.
The will and the wisdom of Rassilon. Is there anyone here to contest the candidate's right to the sash of Rassilon? Is there anyone here to contest the candidate's right to the rod of Rassilon? Is there anyone here to contest the candidate's right to the great key of Rassilon? By custom, with wisdom, and for honor, I shall strike three times. Should no voice be heard by the third stroke, I will, duty bound, invest the candidate as President of the Supreme Council of the Time Lords of Gallifrey.
Ha 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 ha.